MrExcel podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Excel in-depth chapter 22, copying Subtotal. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Subtotal is one of those really, really cool features that can save you a massive amount of time. Let's say that we have to add subtotals to every customer. First of all, you want to sort the data by customer. Click A to Z, so that way all the customers are together. And then back here on the data tab on the right-hand side, something called subtotal. We say at each change in, always change that customer, we want to use the sum function and choose all the numeric fields. When we click OK, very quickly Excel goes through and adds new lines with the subtotals. All right, that's cool. Next thing, see over here, 1, 2, and 3, the group and outline buttons. Let's click the number 2 button. Now we get just the subtotal lines. Even cooler, but this is where it all breaks down. I'm going to copy that data, Control-C to copy. I'm going to go to a new workbook, Control-N for new. Paste, Control-V, and look, they brought all of the rows along instead of just the totals. Oh, horrible, horrible, horrible. All right, so the solution back here is a dialog box that I'm going to bet that you probably haven't seen. It's not the go-to dialog box. It's called Go-To Special. Go-To Special. You can go to Home, Find and Select, Go-To Special. Wait, you couldn't see that. Here, let's take Find and Select, and we'll add it to the Quick Access Toolbar. All right, Home. Find and select Go To Special right there. So it's usually out on the right side of the Home tab. I realize we have a small screen here today. And I want to go to the visible cells only. Go to visible cells only. All right, now when I copy, Control C, look, I'm copying only those individual rows. Control N for new, Control V to paste, and I get just those customer totals, about 25 rows of data. Great summary report from that other data set. Now, Go To Special. Let's do it again. Really cool stuff there on Go-To Special. Sometimes we use visible cells only. Lots of times I use blanks. Sometimes I use formulas. So three things here that are really power Excel tricks that I keep using over and over and over again. But this particular one, Go-To Special visible cells only, there's a shortcut for it. If you hold down Alt and press semicolon, that will do the same thing as Go-To Special visible cells only. So for that one, great shortcut key, Alt and semicolon, will select the visible cells. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.